Thanks for joining us tonight. We are learning new details about the overnight standoff between Minneapolis police and a man wanted for attempted murder.
After multiple hours in wait and as police prepared to fire gas into his home, 54-year-old John Sawchak walked into custody. This is the man wanted for allegedly shooting his neighbor over a tree, a crime that placed the MPD in the national spotlight. Morgan Wolf is here now with new information about this takedown. Morgan.
Police say that Sawchak has a criminal history, knowledge of explosive devices, access to firearms, and mental health issues, all while living in a residential area. The mayor called this a situation, a quote, cocktail that could have erupted at any moment.
This is the Minneapolis Police Department. We have a search warrant.
In early morning hours, neighbors watched and waited.
Been giving him every opportunity to come out peacefully and it's not happening yet.
The man inside the home, John Sawchak, was wanted by police. They say that he had three active arrest warrants at the time he shot his neighbor on October 23rd.
Minneapolis police officers waited for days for the individual to emerge from the house, and he never did. Officers were, however, able to confirm that the individual was inside.
Minneapolis police say that they were in contact with Sawchak's family on Sunday night, and a standoff began at 8:30 p.m. With consideration of his mental health issues, access to firearms, and his knowledge of explosives, MPD brought in crisis negotiators to ease him out. Hours later, they eventually took more physical measures, knocking out windows. Around 1:30 a.m. on Monday morning, Sawchak walked out of his home, surrendering peacefully without harming officers, himself, or his neighbors.
I stand with our police officers. Doing this the right way takes courage. It takes the willingness to de-escalate.
A defensive police chief on Friday over the handling of the situation changed his tone yesterday.
The Minneapolis police somehow did not act urgently enough to prevent that individual from being shot. And to that victim, I say I am sorry.
Today, City Councilmember Emily Koski spoke about how the chief and mayor handled this case, standing by her and other city council members' efforts of holding them accountable.
So I'm grateful to the chief for apologizing. That was 4 days too late, but I'm grateful that we are making progress towards that justice. And I hope that we're going to do everything we possibly can to make sure this never happens again.
Sawchak is being held in the county jail on a $1 million bond. He's facing four felony charges of murder, assault, stalking, and harassment. Police say he was a survivalist and also a hoarder, which has made searching the home difficult as the investigation continues.
All right, thank you, Morgan. And as Morgan mentioned, Sawchak was known to have firearms, and neighbors we spoke with say that they have seen these red flags for years. Neighbors tell us that they were concerned that the behavior seemed to be escalating this summer. One said Sawchak's name came up several times during the neighborhood's national night out back in August. Many of the neighborhood were relieved. The standoff this morning ended peacefully, but they are still frustrated that the problems were not addressed sooner.
I wish they would have arrested him long before he shot his neighbor. Right, so there's this balance. It's like, way to keep the block safe in this particular situation, but could we have avoided the neighbor getting shot?
We've also learned that the next door neighbor, Davis Moturi, who was shot last Wednesday, is now home from the hospital and focusing on his recovery.